In this video, we're going through a quick derivation of the energy density associated with an electric field. Now, we're going to do this in the context of a parallel plate capacitor, where we've already established that the total energy in this capacitor is given by 1/2 CV². And in that formula, C is the capacitance and V is the potential difference across the plates. And we found this energy by calculating the work required to move charge from one plate to the other, one little infinitesimal chunk dq at a time. And I'll post a link to that derivation at the top real quick. Well, in this video, we're going to shift our perspective and say the energy is actually stored in the electric field itself. So the way we think about it is that the electric field gives us an energy density in the space between the plates. So this energy density, we can call that little u, is given by the total energy stored in this capacitor divided by the volume that that electric field is spread out through. But the volume of that region where we have electric field between the plates of a capacitor is just given by the area of the plates multiplied by the plate separation distance, little d. So I'll go ahead and move the 1/2 out in front here. And our total energy stored in the capacitor was 1/2 CV². So the CV squared goes in the numerator. And then the volume between these plates is A times D. Now we can plug in our formula for how capacitance depends on the geometry of the capacitor. And I'll post a link to where this was derived real quick. But we recall that the capacitance is given by epsilon zero A over D. So that replaces the C, and then we still have a V squared, the potential difference squared, over A times D. Okay, so the area of the plates is going to cancel out. And I end up with a 1/2 epsilon zero times V over D all squared. But then we recall that the potential difference V between the plates of a parallel plate capacitor is just given by the electric field strength E multiplied by D. And that's really just because the potential integral becomes trivial when E is a constant. Okay, so the D's cancel out. And I get this result that the electric field energy density is given by 1/2 epsilon zero times big E squared, the electric field strength squared. So that's not a proof, it's more of a motivation, but any region of electric field is going to have an energy density associated with it. And this opens up some really nice calculations for us, where we can get the energy stored by a charge distribution by just integrating this energy density over a region of space. Now, a couple of the problems that we're going to apply this to immediately is the energy stored in a concentric cylindrical shell capacitor, and then the energy stored in a nested spherical shell capacitor. And links to those two videos are posted on the left on the end screen, and I'll see you there.